Hey guys, we are Iron Hound and you're watching Turk TV.
Turk TV?
Yeah! Fuck! What's up guys, you're watching Turk TV and we are here with Iron Hound. Quickly, just around to introduce yourselves and the roles in the band.
I'm Rakshit, I'm the drummer for Iron Hound.
I'm Vivek, I'm the guitarist.
Pritham and I'm the vocalist.
And Rohit, guitarist.
Awesome. So, very quickly, what sort of made Iron Hound happen? What was it that made you guys form the band and some of your influences? So, Pritham.
The hatred, frustration, ego, anything but abnormal. Okay. And our influences, Exodus, Sepultura, and of course, Slayer.
So, what was the idea behind Iron Hound? Is there like the concept like you mentioned? Is it driven by hate?
Yes. It's pretty much the anger we have against the society and with the people around.
This is what you feel every day. Not something deep or whatever. It's just
silkboard traffic actually did.
Silkboard traffic and definitely contribute to anger.
Traffic did actually make me
obviously.
Talk about
influence,
silkboard traffic, that's what it is.
You guys have been playing a lot of gigs and all that. Just wanted to get an essence of what do you think is like the Bangalore scene.
The kind of bands that are coming out are growing actually, with a lot of genres coming up, people are trying out a lot of new stuff. And yes, it's coming back up again, a lot of bands around. So yeah, pretty good for people.
One good thing is that now, at least back then, bands never had any concept of actually hitting the studio. Very few bands used to hit the studio, record material and be serious about like releasing material, like playing live shows tight. Mm-hmm. Now bands jam more, they're actually, you see a lot more releases happening, especially in the last 2-3 years. A lot of releases are coming out, and I think, like just yesterday, I think Sonaksh put out his material also, like yeah, props to that, Sonaksh.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah, I think the scene is, like it's definitely grown from what it was.
And people have started listening to metal, they have gathered their influences, this, that. So yes, I think they are, you know, like growing. Everything is growing in India, so let it grow.
Earlier, we used to pay money to just get into one college and play for 15 minutes and they'd chase out when we are at the 10th minute because we sound obscene, we sound vulgar or rubbish. They just chase us out, take our money and fuck us over.
But
now we have more venues. I think the best time for metal in Bangalore was when Kaira was around and Underground used to happen there. Putrid Pie was one of the decimating kids. Then it became like one gig a year, which is Bangalore Open Air. Now it's picking up again, like Vikram Das shows. Vikram Das shows, Sandesh Das shows. Now Charlie is doing, Charlie got back doing that, and even I, so we started doing shows now.
Do you think that the social media and the internet is playing
Yes, it does.
Yeah,
See, the thing is, social media has helped us a lot because compared to the old days where we had to actually pass around demos, going to places, physically giving it, here gives us a platform to actually share stuff to various people, not just within the area, but people around the globe. You know? So, people get to explore. And there are not just the social media, you got apps as well, where, you know, wherein you can just pay some money and get your
really
songs
like
out.
Nowadays, everyone is playing good because we have a lot of tutorials on YouTube. On other medium, so you know, like seeing it, even I learned that way. So like everyone is playing good, everyone is improving nowadays.
And finding bandmates, finding people to actually jam with, because now
communicating.
Yeah, because now you have like if suppose someone puts up a video, say a cover, and suppose I'm looking forward to form a death metal band, and someone puts there's a guitarist who puts up an obituary cover. I'm like, okay, fine. Like I know now.
Yeah.
Otherwise, back in the day, it had to be through actual like contacts. You go through like, bro, do you know someone? I'm looking for someone. Now it's much easier.
One thing or whatever, multiple things you feel could change in the Indian metal scene for the better.
Everyone should
please
be
start. People need to start picking up the drums more. Less guitarists, more drummers.
Drummers and bassists, please.
A lot more drummers and bassists. We have a lot of Steve-Wise around. We want some DiGiorgios and...
Such agree. A lot of people underestimate the bass guitar. I mean, since I play the instrument myself, they don't realize how important it is.
Guys, those of you all trying to form bands, bass is really important. Please do go for that. you want to pick up something, do go for a bass basis.
Just don't be scared to approach even organizers or labels, like whatever. Just don't be haphazard with the way you're going about things. Know that, you know, you can just like play a couple of shows, get a release out, and then sort of, you know, like, just it's much easier if you just know where you're going rather than just hoping and praying.
And there's going to be a lot of people pointing fingers at you. Maybe they will not like your style of music, but then just go for it. You and like it, you like what you do.
One biggest thing is stop programming drums. Just get a live drummer. Just play live drums. It's probably going to cost you $1,000 more.
And perform on stage. I can't stress this enough. Too many bands I've seen just come and jam on stage again. There's no energy, there's no performance part of it. People are actually paying money to watch you perform.
And yeah, kids don't do drugs.
we don't advocate any substance of it.
And you morons thought us metalheads are all drug addicts. So what next for Ironhound? Do you guys have a plan? Are you gonna hit the studio?
Yes,
what's
we are recording stuff. So soon it will be released
in a month or something.
Okay. We have recorded one or two of them. So you just need to finish it. So
like we just sat on the drum, like we like, you know, most of, like he wrote, yeah, like wrote
just gathered thoughts.
Yeah, gathered thoughts. That's it.
Moving to the next question, the final part of this interview. Please give us the worst PJ or the most epic joke you're aware of.
While going TP in the poo poo, do you something, guys? This is what I was talking about. What do we say to PJs?
Our lives are PJs.
Life itself is a PJ. You just, we're not rich enough to make biographies to show you how fucked up it is. But then, yeah, we've made it. But then, apart from PJs, I'll just say one thing, guys. Just whatever you want to do, go for it. Don't give up. Don't be shy. There'll be a lot of people pointing fingers at you. There'll be a lot of problems coming your way. You might not have members to help you out. Or you might not have time or anything. But then just stop. Don't stop what you're doing. If you're on the thing of writing
the
songs,
the best joke I heard in a decade now. Nikhil, yelidiya pa. Marey koga pa tikhams kando.
Awesome. So there you have it, guys. Ironhound. If you haven't checked them out, crawl out of the hole you're living in and check them out, man.
Yeah. Stay there.